all we are now going to do, we are going to copy it, and let's get back to stylesheet.css, and here we will first of all create the table holder class that was created here to hold this table element. Here it goes. So we are getting back to the stylesheet.css, and the very first thing that we are going to do, we are going to check it with a particular background, for say with a yellow background. Let's get back to our project, reload, and we can see that the table holder class name is practically appearing right beneath this list holder item. Now if we get back to index.html, this is the table element which is appearing within this table holder class. So in the second case, all we are now going to do, we are going to customize the table. This is the table which is appearing within this class name. All we are now going to do, first of all, we are going to set for a width here. If we provide 980px, let's go for it, reload, and we can see that 980px it is. In the second case, now all we need to do, we need to provide some border elements, we need to provide some padding, and of course this margin thing. And first of all, let's get back to our project. There it goes. Now we will be customizing the tr element which is present within a table and which in turn is present inside a table holder class. So first of all, we are creating it. If you find it that nothing could be done over here, nothing should be put in this particular case, we are practically not customizing our row elements, then just leave it. Do not put anything inside it, but all you need to do, you need to create this particular selector name in an order for future reference. If you want to make some modification, if you want to make some customization, so that you can get back and continue from where you left it off. Now in the third case, the column element which is appearing within a row element, which is appearing within a table element, and in turn which is appearing within this class name of table holder. Now we have to customize this column. So first of all, get back to your project, and we are stating that the padding should be 10px. There it goes. We have successfully provided a padding of 10px inside, and this is the background color of the table holder that has been created. So what if we want to put a background color here? We have provided a background color for this particular table. Now what if we want to create a border right for all those individual cells over here? So let's get back to our project, and for this column element, we will be providing a border right of 1px solid, and what it is, what should be the color? FFF. And another thing, all we are doing now, we are practically removing this background. We can remove it, or we can simply comment it out. There it goes. So we have commented out this property of background FF0 in case of this table holder class name. Now just save it, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that everything is back in order. What was the color of this particular thing? Let's get back here, C9C. So this is the color code. We will be now getting back to our project, reload, and there goes the color C9C. Let's increase this padding. There it goes. The padding has been increased right now, so we can see that it is a little bit more spacious. Now here comes the important thing. First of all, let's remove this width property, or we can comment it out from here. So you can see that all those things are practically experimental. We need to make some experiment with it, and there it goes. We can see that these things are right into the action. On the other hand, if we now get back to table holder, what if we want this table to appear in the exact middle of this table holder class? So that is what we are going to do. Here into this dot table holder, we are providing here a margin of 0px auto. Remember the syntax of margin 0 auto? We have made a mistake over here. We have created it inside this dot table holder. Practically, we are now instructing our web page to align this particular class into the exact middle of this web page. Now you have confined it within a 1000px container. Remember that we have created it inside the mother wrapper, and it is a 1000px container, and which is being aligned into the exact central position of this particular web page. That is why it won't be set into anything, because we have set the maximum permissible width that we have provided to our mother wrapper class name. Hence, it won't be working for this table holder class. But instead, now if we get back to table, and if we put this particular property of the table, if we set the margin of this table, instructing that it should align itself into the exact central position of the same particular class name here, which is this one. So get back to your project and reload, and you can see that it is practically working here. The table is been aligned into the exact middle of your web page. Now let's consider these individual cells. And another thing, we have created here a border, right? Instead, put a border, reload and see the result, and you can see that this will be the result. Now in the second case, all we want our table to appear a little bit more spacious. These individual cells, all of these cells, those should be separated by a certain value. For say 10px, we want them to be separated for 10px here. So we will be getting back to our project. Now here comes the most interesting factor. I would like to ask you to put your concentration into it. For say, if we want to enhance this particular cell spacing as we had done in our previous case, if we get back to index.html and if we now mention this cell spacing property here, for say to 10, get back and reload. This is the same exact thing that we want to create with our CSS properties. Now, just undo this thing. We don't want to use any kind of inline property here. We want to make these changes practically with this stylesheet.css and reset your condition. If we observe into our table, this is the table element that has been created. So if we observe here, we needed to provide something like this to make it appear as if this one. But this won't be the same case, as we have priorly used this margin zero auto condition here. We have aligned this table into the exact central position, so we cannot use the same margin property here below. Now what if we provide here a margin top of 10px? Get back to your project and reload. You can see that this is not the exact scenario that we have encountered over here. We practically separated ourselves from each other, and what it is doing here, the table is practically leaving a margin top of 10px. This is not the same exact thing that we intended to do. So what should be done over here? Get back to your project. First of all, undo the change that you have made into your CSS. And this is the part where we will be using border spacing. And we will be using another property here, border collapse separate. Now what it is doing exactly? We want to provide a particular spacing into our cells, so that is why we have mentioned that with this syntax. On the other hand, we need to appear them as a separate unit, as a separate cell, so that is why we have provided this border collapse with a separate property. Now what it exactly does, press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. and you can see that all those cells into it, those are practically getting separated. This is the thing that practically we want to create. We wanted our cells to disperse, to be separated from each other. So that is why we have used this particular property of border spacing and another particular property of this border collapse, separate. And in the second case, for each individual cells, we have mentioned that the padding should be 20 pixels. You may keep it to 10 pixels and see the result again. The padding is now reduced. That is why it is appearing so. But the cells are being separated from each other. So that's all for today's tutorial. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.